Hello everyone, I wish you a warm welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are going to see how to launch and play Shining Nikki on PC. From now you're able to watch it on your screen. We will be able to effortlessly download and set up Shining Nikki and play this game on the Windows PC using our gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all folks, the first thing to do is to open our favorite internet browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's go to this URL I have highlighted in green. Now, you can discover on the screen. You don't need to type it, because I provided the link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We arrived here on our own site of Usitility, exactly where we get a in-depth description on how you can download Shining Nikki on computer. We browse down a tad and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we reach the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Shining Nikki on our PC. It is now obvious that we have a great deal of advantages of running that emulator. Then, we will start downloading the Shining Nikki by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on it, and the download takes no time at all. Voila! This is the download. It's an executable file. What we are going to do is to run the executable file, so we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the laptop or device. We said yes. I reduce the browser to start to see the installation software better. The installer is very simple to use. It is made up of a couple of options, install and setup path. I am going to talk about what setup path does. We just click on it. And now we see that we got here the path where the emulator will be set up. If we have to change this directory, we must click on this browse button. So we choose another directory and set up the emulator where we desire. To keep it simple, just set it by default. I simply click back, so I simply click on install. Voila! The installation commences and it is going to move forward together with the download of all these megabytes which are shown on that screen. At the time you save it on your hard drive, it could possibly be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed could go at a higher speed or slower, determined by your type of connection and according to the performance of the emulator servers. Immediately they're progressing extremely fast. The download is done, and straight away it continues on with the installation step. The setup will take more or less time depending on the power of your PC. The more efficient it is, the shorter the software setup time and vice versa. If we join the download and install stage, it may take a considerably long time, so show patience. It is by now finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has been started successfully. As you can observe, down here, we have a progress bar which will fill up, so when it comes to the end, the emulator is going to be launched for the very first time. The truth is the emulator has already been started, there for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can discover, it created a couple of icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is definitely the one we are interested in. Anytime we are planning to operate Shining Nikki on the PC, we double-click that icon and therefore use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or anything such as that. In reality, it is an icon that we may probably never ever make use of. Why don't we do the next phase, which is actually a must, and that's to begin to browse the Google Play Store. As you can observe, the Google Play is launched. At this point we are required to sign in. At this time when we're on this page, we are required to accomplish this next step that is mandatory. Therefore we click on Sign In. At this moment it says Checking Info. It might once in a while get stuck in Checking Info, and this fails to move forward. If that's the case, you can attempt to connect to your account after a few hours and it'll most probably be fixed. At this moment we are going to provide our email address and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. For instance, you can use the very same email you use at this moment in your YouTube account. Therefore, I am going to submit my information and I'll revisit immediately after I have completed it. That's all. Data typed. Discover Google welcoming us and providing us the twos. We are going to approve them simply by clicking on I agree. Following, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it checked and this will create a backup of the files on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We mouse click on accept. Google Play Store is launched without need to open it manually and completely on its own. To install the app game, we are required to go to the Android emulator desktop by clicking that icon indicated in green. Today that we are on the desktop of that emulator for Android, we observe that we now have there the install game button. We just click on that button. Right here we have the Android game. Let's press there on the install choice that I'm displaying now in green. Therefore it will start the software setup. Straight away it should download on your PC and set up the game. It will take a while or it may be amazingly quickly. It all relies on our own internet connection. It's as of now ended installing. Back to the emulator desktop by hitting this specific option that I am presenting in green, that allows you to launch Shining Nikki for the first time. Let me click on this My Games choice above. We're by now on the emulator desktop, and so we are about to simply click on the new Shining Nikki app icon that has been generated. This game is started for the first time. Currently there we have it. I can also click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the sound level of that emulator. It is here. We use the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume, this way we will not rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of the emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we will turn on the big screen, for which we have two options. That is the very first one. We then click on this icon which I'm identifying in green. Then the screen is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. Assuming that we desire to play the application in full screen, we click that icon. And then we would presently be experiencing and enjoying the video game in full screen function. To exit the 100% screen mode, push the F11 key. And then we would likely currently play in normal computer screen setting. At this moment I am going to explain you the computer keys mapping which is actually rather appealing. This way we may be able to operate the game much more effortlessly. The first point is to click this software icon. And here you will be able to complete the recommended adjustments. I am about to let the default configuration, but if you prefer to change this, you can do it now without having problem. Clearly, the emulator is completely in our own language. Once in a while it happens that the emulator is presented in the wrong language, as an example, in Chinese. And therefore to set it in the appropriate language we go there to the cogwheel. Then here throughout many other configurations, we simply click on the language drop down. We may very well decide on the language we prefer, English, Japanese, etc. After the language is chosen, we should save, the emulator will restart, along with the game app. Next time we run it, will of course be in the preferred language. At this point, there is another thing that we have to take into account, and it is that we will get an email telling that a new machine has been connected to this Google account. It should question us if we're the ones who have connected that device. Yup, we shouldn't be troubled, simply because the emulator is behaving like an Android device. In order to see which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. And so we go here to the model selection. And now we notice that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for our video user demo. I believe you liked it, especially that you found it useful. In that case, give it a superb like, subscribe, and if you have comments, concerns or suggestions, put them in the comment box down below. You could even leave comments on my Twitch channel. I perform live streams from time to time. You have it down below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Click on any of these instructional videos which are usually showing up on the suggestion of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the future video tutorials. Bye.